All right, just some quick thoughts on this guy right here. This badass guy right here. Canon C400. I'm a Canon shooter through and through. I have a couple C70s, an R5C, mirrorless camera, and they've done the job for me just fine. But I also have a lot of RF glass. I'm shooting on a 24-105 2.8 right now. So it's really 35-150 on the C70. Not the end of the world, but the C400 being 6K full frame will utilize that lens and all the other RF lenses I have. This is better suited. I mean, it was meant for that. So, that being said, it's functioning in its true purpose, and I'm not sacrificing anything. I will get rid of one of my C70s, which is heartbreaking because I love these cameras. I usually shoot with two C70s, but I know I can get away with one C70, turn up the sharpening maybe just a little bit. I was debating on whether to keep in an R5C and get rid of both C70s, but I can't. I love the DGO sensor, I love the look. But from what I've seen from CVP and Pro AV, they did a really, really good job with color grading, showing some images, the ins and outs, the tech stuff I'm not gonna go into. You've heard that ad nauseum, I'm sure, if you have any interest in the C400. I'm just coming from a Canon shooter perspective, and I'm really happy. I think I'll get a lot of mileage out of that camera. I'm almost tempted to get two C400s and get rid of both C70s. But we'll see. I want to see how they pair together. If they pair together, just find a B camera, a C70. That works for me. So, September can't come soon enough. This is going to be a lot of fun shooting with this camera. I can tell you for sure. I do a lot of talking head stuff, maybe some sports stuff, automotive. It checks all the boxes. It really checks all the boxes. And the triple ISO. I'm not an event shooter. I'm not shooting concerts or, you know, bar scenes or something. But I do have a couple ideas for commercials that would be well suited in that 12,800 ISO, where I could shoot in a bar, not bringing a whole bunch of lights. You know, just some minimal keys, you know, a low percentage, not drawing a lot of attention, because I'd like to shoot this stuff with regular people in mind, you know, in the bar. And I know if I had that 12, I could probably do it with the 32, probably just fine. But 12,800, that's beautiful. So in my head, I can already see these shots playing out, and I'm looking forward to it. I'm really looking forward to it. This is what I've been waiting for. And I'm, you know what? Everybody complained about Canon dragging their feet and why it wasn't it years ago. How come you didn't do this? How come everybody's going to complain about how come you didn't do this? How come you didn't do that? Where was this? Where was that? It gets old. Just, you know, be grateful for what we have, the tools we have. Crazy. Compared to 10 years ago, 20 years ago. Watch a 1980s movie. I'm 59 years old. Watch an 80s movie, which was just fine in the day, and and what low-level crap it was, to be honest with you. A lot of it. Anyways, so I'm excited. I'm excited for the future. I'm excited for Canon. Canon does well. Everybody's going to do a little bit better, you know? Everybody's going to... The competition's great, no matter how you look at it. So, I'll be putting out some C400 stuff when I get it, for sure. And, you know, I'm not knocking anybody else, but where Canon was coming up short, caught up to everybody. And I saw some tests with the rolling shutter. It's so fast, it's not a thing. And all, you know, some other shortcomings with the full frame and the RF and blah, blah, blah. It's caught up, and in a lot of ways, it surpassed everybody. So, everybody else has got work to do. It's good though. You know, the end result is we get a better final product. And the C70 served me just fine for the lull in throwing out cameras all the time. And that's an issue in itself. Chasing the next one. Like the C400, I'm gonna sit on that for a very long time. That's my plan. We'll see how it plays out. I'm a little bit of a gear junkie too, just like everybody else, but I don't jump brands. That's kind of crazy to me, because the glass is what we're really buying, and RF glass is second to none. So that's where I'm at. I'm excited. This was just a little ramble, like, you know, another Canon person shooting, looking forward to the future and shooting the C400 and see what we get. So, all good. This thing's gonna kill it. Yeah. All right.